6:35, we check back in now with Mike Eppel for a look at business news. Mike.
Good morning, Tammy. We're looking this morning at fearless forecasts for 2019 in the real estate market as we go into the new year, and after what has been somewhat of a choppy year for the GTA housing market specifically, both REMAX and Royal LePage are forecasting just moderate price gains in the new year. Now, a lot of this is riding, of course, on how much more interest rates go up. They've gone up 3 times over the course of this year, and this has led to a rebalancing. One of the commentators actually says this has actually been the mythical soft landing for the real estate market. Consider that we were going up in some cases year over year by double digits on percentage basis, and things kind of stabilized this year, even in the midst of rising borrowing costs. The latest problem, though, for the GTA market is actually a lack of supply, which has kept prices elevated. Well, the first two trading days of this week have been pretty much exhausting. Huge swings top to bottom for the Wall Street benchmarks, and perhaps more of the same coming up in the midweek trade today. On Monday, we saw a 600-point swing for the Dow. Yesterday, it was a more than 400-point swing for the Dow Jones Industrials Average. All of this on political risk, trade issues between the U.S. and China. Some positive signals coming out of China about the idea of reducing tariffs on U.S. auto imports, and that could be a break in the China-U.S. trade dispute or battle, whatever you want to call it. The other factor now at play is the arrest and subsequent bail for the chief financial officer of Huawei. U.S. President Donald Trump in an interview with Reuters saying he could intervene in that entire case if it were to lead to a deal between the U.S. and China on trade. British Prime Minister Theresa May will find out her future later today. A vote of no confidence will be held in the British Parliament after the failure to do a deal on Brexit, and lots of questions about the leadership of the current government and whatever any of this could mean for the Brexit negotiations going into the new year. Investors saying not so much this morning. They're sending London stocks up 1.25%. And Melanie, we've got the price for oil jumping this morning. It is up by more than 2% because U.S. inventories are falling and OPEC's cutting production. And in a year that has seen some very low prices for oil, we could actually be ending on an up note. And of course, we'll be tracking what that means for the price for gas, which actually came down, I think, 2 cents overnight.
Which is always a pleasant treat. All right. Yeah. Thank you, Mike. Have a wonderful
day. You're welcome.